Hey boys, hey girls. Yeah, the spring fling this year is gonna be on the 9th of May, which is the Saturday after the New Orleans Jazz Fest. More in another video. Oh man, this is some fine beer here. Yum, yum, yum. Let's get on with the menu for tonight and go from here. A boy, a girl, a yum.
Hey boys, hey girl. We're gonna haul off and make us a Southern favorite family dinner. Cause the family's coming over. Gonna smother us fry and smother some pork chops with some collard greens, crowder peas, mashed potatoes, and yum. And then pork chops gonna make their own. Oh man. Own brown gravy with just salt and pepper on. That's it. And we're gonna make some cornbread also. Yum, this is gonna be a Southern family favorite extravaganza explosion. Tongue will come out and beat your brains out. Kind of deal. So, I got some bacon and some tasso. Hickory smoked bacon, hickory smoked tasso. Gonna put that in the oven and get it cooking. Cause we need the grease and the pieces, parts of meat. So let's ever so carefully measure us up some hot diet water in this pot. And I think this is about a 6 quart or 4 quart. It's that size pot. And we're gonna do the same thing in this pot. And okay, let's see. This one say that was 4 quarts, so this one here must be 3 quarts. I ain't gonna turn it upside down on my face with that water in there. The hot water, hot diet water. I got 2 pots with about 1 knuckle each up to the first knuckle with hot water. I'm gonna ever so carefully, look, pay attention down here, boy, come on. Ever so carefully measure out some Trinity. And this is frozen Trinity. And you can buy this at your stove if you live in South Louisiana. And maybe in some parts other than thereof. Now, see, it's called seasoning blend. Made by Pick Sweet. Turn your head sideways, boy. Go bring these to the barrel. Collard greens. Crowder peas, all right? Let's start out with about a teaspoon of salt in each pot. Heaping. Where the pepper? Come here, son of a bitch. Put some pepper in both of them. Now, and don't sniff it. You be sneezing. Now for the collard greens, you need a little bit of vinegar. And that's what this is mostly. Very little hot flavor in there. So a couple dashes of that. Little bit of sugar. About like that. And garlic powder. This is an easy, easy meal. Garlic powder in there for the peas. And burl. Then we're gonna fry some pork chops. We have to do them pork chops in batches though. Now I didn't want to add too much salt at first. Because we got, get this bacon grease here. And it's gonna come out of there. And it's going to salt this up some more. Get some in there. There's some in here. Oh, Tasso, stay up there, boy. We're going to bust up all the rest of this and distribute it between the two pots. This one's ready. This one's on a smaller burner. Smaller pot. Be all right. We're swapping now. They both coming up to the barrel. Let's see. We just cutting up with pig sweet today. Chopped collard greens. Oh, it said cut to open. Even got look, directions. It don't say tab. It say cut. I'll get ready to cuss it too. You know how I am. So let me get my Cutco brand. See, Cutco brand. Scissor. Miss JB's nephew. My nephew is a. Put him in the right pot now, boy. Collins in there. He's a Cutco distributor. So we get all that stuff. Let's see here. Hey, one more bag in there, GB, just for the whole family coming by. You know they all gonna want some of this. Now, we gonna cover the seminat and ignore the instructions on the bag because they ain't right. You don't know what they're talking about. Get them crowder peas in there. Yum, pick sweet. All natural, fresh from the farm to you. We're gonna let them go. We're gonna ignore the instructions on the bag of them too. So, they're gonna have to come back up to the barrel. We're gonna cover them and let them simmer for a couple of hours. We're gonna also eat some of this bacon, and they put some in there too. This is my sampler. We gotta cut that tasso up. A little bit in there, a little bit. We're gonna put them in both. Easy, easy. See, back off camera, boy. Tell you some off. Put some in there. Put some over here. Repeat. So let me do that. Not sure like being in the kitchen where it's nice and warm. Where the deer and the buffalo roam. And seldom is heard no bullshit from the family. Because they get to eat. Now, tasso, we chop that up. It's been cooked in the oven and go distribute it between the stuff. So what is tasso? Think of a smoked ham on Cajun steroids. Not your ordinary steroids, Cajun steroids. So look down here, boy, down here. Put you some in there. Put you some over in here. In the greens. I ain't covered it yet because I need to put the damn tasso in there. Already got the bacon in there. We're gonna let these simmer down. Now that I got these two long-term things going, I gotta get some pork chops cooking. Because these can just sit here and go and cook. And yeah, the stove dirty. That's good. We cook every damn day. We clean on Wednesday only. And that done already passed, and it's dirty again. So now, how you like that shit? Oh, this meal gonna take up 5 burners on my stove. I got 6 burner stove. We're gonna use all 5. Oh, we're going to use 5 today. I sure like having a big kitchen. All right, let's move on. Get the pork chops out the fridge, season with salt and pepper, and chunk them in some fat in a pot and brown them good, good on both sides. The better you brown them, the better your gravy gonna come out. Trust me, boy. We're gonna do this in an iron pot too. Kinda like Miss JB's head. Now, oh, you wanna, which way is zoom the other way? Uh-oh, let's see here. Camera panning too fast again. Damn it, camera, don't pan that fast then. Well, see, you want to wrench your pork chops off because they've been cut on a bandsaw after they've been playing leapfrog like that. That's what they've done. Yeah. So, rinse them off because they got bones in them. See, bone. You got to get the bone fragments that done spread around the meat. So we're gonna wrench them in the sink and pat them dry in salt and pepper them. And then go fry them. Okay, patty cake dry over there. Play leapfrog again. Yeah.
All right, so what you wanna do is salt and pepper the hell out of them. And then cut through the little rib of fat around the outside, the little outer ring, because they'll when it shrink, the fat's going to shrink faster than the meat and make it curl up in the pan.
Take this one, drop it in the fat. Get another. Drop it in. That's it. You got to do these in batches. The fat starts popping. It's too hot. Cut the pot down some.
And you want a nice brown color on them like that. Could have shook it a little further. Whoa. Get back, Tammy. See that color? We'll do that on all sides of all of them. You can take them out and eat them just like that on the sandwich. Maxwell Street Polish or Maxwell Street pork chop sandwich sound comes to mind. We'll do that in another video. Let me finish frying all these up. What we're gonna do? See the pan we cooked the bacon in? We're gonna take them out of here, put them on there, keep them in the oven on warm while they finish cooking. And see the bacon fat that's left on there? Yum. Don't worry about that. It's Cajun soul food. And it's healthy. And it's very good. Not too healthy, but it is very good. Okay, after two batches, we gotta pause and get the grimmies off the bottom of this pan and save them so we don't burn them. And so we're gonna scrape them off. Gotta scrape them off. This is where your gravy gonna come from. See right there? Take them and save them in another container. And they'll come off. You're gonna have to coax them.
coax them off with a dragger. And I can say you're one of them draggers. But let's continue. So like I said, we're taking and doing these in batches. You like that? And we'll finish them off in the oven. Hot oven. So get you some diet water in here. Then we're going to take an achy, breaky heart, all the stuff off the bottom. You see how it's turning brown. And you remember the stuff that I reserved in the cup? It's gone in there too. Now this will not make a thick gravy unless you add a thickener to it. But it is a delicious gravy, just like it is. Come on, move out of the way. Here's them little parts, them Grammys. Oh, cool, let's get them in there too. That was unedited mess all over the kitchen. With kitty, Hello Kitty cup. Okay. Did it get on you, Cammy? Yeah, we got some splatter. We're gonna put more of that. The dog down there cleaning up the splatters. Good dog. Like a mopping dog. Check on the green stuff and make some cornbread fresh from a mix. Yeah, yum.
JB got a sample. Yum. Double yum. Now, after you done remove your poke chops and you got your diet water in there, go ahead and put them back. And I'm going to reserve meat too and put them in the oven and cover them with water. And that's it. And let them simmer for about 45 minutes, an hour. Bury you some potatoes for your mashed potatoes. And let's try it. Man, this is some good beer right here. Man, Joe, this is better than, as good as what you sent. Cool. So, for the cornbread, get you some more fat. Is this a healthy meal? Oh, hell yeah, it's healthy. Miss JB gonna help and make the cornbread. I done already started the skillet screaming hot with fat in it. She putting the egg in there. You're gonna whoop the batter together. You're supposed to have milk in it too. She done already made, started on the cream potatoes. I may have this out of order. I don't know. No, I think she just busts up the potatoes and put them in there. So, this is the cornbread batter. And she whooping it real fast, too. Now she pouring it in the pan, and we're going to go put that in there. Yeah, she ain't finished peeling the taters yet. That's what's up. Bake the cornbread according to directions. Put you some whooping cream in there and whoop them about, add salt and pepper and butter. That's right, she already put some butter in there, about a whole stick. She mixing it, checking it for salt and pepper. Look, need more salt and pepper. Okay, done that, got it. Nah, cream potato, she out the room. Finished. I want to eat, she said, JB. I said, all right, well, all the grandkids, everybody was here. They had a cornbread and the collard greens. And crowd of peas, yum. You see that meat just fall apart. And then the cream potatoes. Yeah, them pork chops is some good. I brawled me the last two and had them with no gravy. Just ate them like that. Man, they're good like that too. They're good in the gravy. And oh man, look at that. Gravy just falling off. Look at the butter. It's going to slide off the cornbread down into the damn collard greens. Oh no, butter. Butter, come back. Yum, yum. This is one of the finest southern meals in the world. This was a pretty good beer. It's all right. This one here, this Irish Channel, man, that's some fine beer right there. I think that may be arriving up somewhere in Sound Beach.